I was at UN from 2012 doing an undergrad in chemistry and molecular physics, and then stayed on to do a PhD until 2021. After my PhD, I was, to be honest, not entirely sure where I wanted to go within an industry. I was fairly sure I wanted to do something related to software and data analytics, but I didn't really know what direction I wanted to go. So I started looking for other areas, for employers who were interested in people with a STEM background, but weren't looking for very advanced programming and software and data analytics skills. I think the transferable skills that Capgemini were interested in were your communication skills, so particularly with your ability to present and communicate clearly and effectively, particularly quite complex topics. They were also looking for problem-solving skills, so largely in the coding exercises that we did, they weren't really interested in whether I could code. They were far more interested in whether I could work with the people who were helping me and puzzle through and work it all out, and actually whether I would ask for help or just sit there struggling. I think one thing that I wish I had known as a student, both as an undergraduate and as a PhD starting out, was that there are lots of employers out there who are actually interested in PhDs. They value the PhD, they value the work you put in and the skills you gain doing it. And you don't just have, a PhD is not just a route through to academia. There are lots of other options out there.